Today we're going to show some of the controls and screenshots on a GAA 600 Scotchman upcut non-ferrous cold saw. So we'll just briefly go over some of the screens. Okay, when you first put your main power on, you're going to have the blue light lit. Scotchman will come up on the screen. You do need to press on that button, get rid of that light. Then we can go into our different screens. We're going to touch menu. Let's go into, the menus as they appear here. Maintenance basically tells you some of the things to look for on a daily and weekly basis. To get back to the next screen, I can go back to menu or I can scroll back on my arrows. Next thing let's go into is the setup screen. This is where you set your parameters for your kerf of your blade and also the saw zero on this list. That is an offset for your blade height adjustment. So let's say you wanted your blade height set at 200 millimeter and it wasn't quite 200 millimeter right on the money. You can adjust this number up or down to make that blade height match your desired amount. To get into the parameters, we'll go into the password screen, 7890. And this is some of your acceleration, deceleration, position speed, that sort of thing. This would be something that probably doesn't need to be changed, and if it does, probably be a good idea to talk to the factory here before you change any parameters in there. So let's get back out of that. Next one, the manual screen. And in the manual screen, you do have to have the selector switch on manual, so the hand is manual, or we can flip over to auto here. So in the manual screen, I can move my shuttle vise back and forth to jog to position. Also, I can adjust the cut height of the saw blade. So it's set at 40 millimeters now. Let's say we want to set it to 50, we just punch it in, hit enter, and we're set at a different parameter. So we'll go back to 40 here. Okay. And then the last screen is your auto screen. This is what you're going to run in when you're cutting parts. So you also have your cut height adjustment for your saw blade. This will tell you once you get up and running in a program what your length is that you have entered, and also the quantity of the materials that for parts that you want done, and it will actually count them off as the parts are being cut. So let's go into select a program. So we have 10 different programs, and in each program we have 30 different lines that we can enter into each program. Okay, this one does have some values in it, so I'm going to get back out of that. I'm going to go into program 2. This also has some values. Let's change some of these. Let's say the first line we want it to be 50 millimeter, and we want 3 pieces of that, so I can enter that. Second line, let's go to 100 millimeter and do 2 pieces there. Hit enter. Okay, now it says that we have selected line 1 and we asked if we want to continue or restart. And we're not in the middle of a program now, we're just at the beginning, so we want to just restart. It'll start out cutting our 50 millimeter lengths, quantity of 3, and then it'll jump down to do our 100 millimeter quantity of 2. Once it reaches the next line, if it's got 0 entered in a value, it'll stop. So let's go ahead and run that. So start my saw motor. Go to auto. Going to make a trim cut. Come back and index our part length. Cycle in. Going to cut our quantity of 3. And now you can come back. It's counting the numbers that we have done complete out of the desired amount. Now it's switched over to our 100 millimeter. We want 2 parts there, so it'll count up to 2, and then it will shut off. Okay? So let's go back to our program list. Go back into program two. Now let's say that on the next job, we want to cut a couple different pieces that we might already have programmed in here. Let's do 150 millimeter in that one and two pieces. Okay, now we don't want to start over from line one again because we've got those parts counted. We want to start on line four. So I'm going to select line four, enter. So now we're going to start on a 300 millimeter part and it'll do one of those and then it will jump up to the 150 millimeter and do two of those. One other screen that we didn't talk about here yet is our alarm screen. So once we punch on it, let's say we have an alarm of some sort going off, like the hood being open, it will come up and tell you what that alarm is. And so you have to clear that alarm before you can run in the automatic mode. So we'll close that back down. So that's how to run an automatic program in the saw. If you were in the manual mode, we would switch over to the manual position. You would start your saw blade, clamp your clamps manually, and then to make your saw blade raise through the material, you would push the two palm buttons, and the saw blade is going to come up and cut your material. When you let loose, it's going to drop back down, unclamp your parts, take your piece out. Now, in the manual mode, it ignores the upper stroke setting. So it's going to just cut through that profile until you let go of your buttons. This is your hood raise switch. You're going to get materials in and out inside your hood cavity. Also, your blade speed upward is adjusted here, and these two adjustments are for your vise pressure regulator clamps on your indexing vise and also on your main vise. A brief overview of the Scotchman GAA 690 upcut non-ferrous automatic coal saw.